Hi, I'm Sam here at Rick Jones Pianos with one of my favorite grand piano models that we get in here. And we get it fairly often since we're here in Beltsville, Maryland, not too far from Baltimore, which is where Kanabe was originally founded in 1837. Kanabe was one of two notable Maryland, Baltimore piano factories, other being Charles Steef, which are no longer in production in their original factories or original country. And like the story with many American piano makers in the 20th century, they changed hands multiple times, and very few of them survive anymore. Kanabe is, as I understand it, made by Samick now in Korea, at least last I checked, using similar designs. Although in my opinion, it doesn't feel, in my opinion, quite the same as one made in the United States. The original Kanabe company merged into American Piano Company in 1908, which itself merged into Aeolian, Weber and Pianola Company. Piano and Pianola Company in 1930. That became an Aeolian American. The original Baltimore factory was closed. The factory was moved to Rochester, New York, where, and by the way, with American Piano Company, that was also a merger with Chickering and eventually Mason and Hamlin, both Boston firms plus some others. So a lot of smaller but good quality piano companies facing the troubles economically of the early 20th century basically banded together for survival, and that's what Aeolian American was. These pianos were made in Rochester, New York until 1982. And as I mentioned, they're very common here in Maryland, since Kanabe had a lot of name recognition here. I'm convinced, I don't have first-hand evidence of it, but I'm convinced that they must have really concentrated their target audience for the Kanabe pianos in this area, which is why we get these pianos much more often than, say, Chickering's in our store, which must have been targeted more to the northeast of this country. So, and it's, as I mentioned, one of my favorite pianos to work on and play and listen to, because I think Kanabe represents it's an earlier tradition of piano making. I mentioned they were founded in 1837. Pianos sounded quite different back then. They were made differently. And although the process of modernization was something that Kanabe was willing to do, compared to like an old, completely wood-frame piano in the early 1800s, they still kept a design, at least the way they designed their pianos, they kept in mind a bit of the older sound that 19th century pianos had, including their own. They did make pianos then. And that's why I like this particular grand model so much, the 5'2" Baby Grand. It has a really, I think, unique sound, especially in the melody range. And because the tail of this piano is kind of wide for its size, it has a larger soundboard area, and especially deep, very punchy deep bass, more than you would expect a Baby Grand to have, and this is consistent with this model, even when Kanabe was controlled by Aeolian American, because they kept the same design, same scale design, same plate soundboard bridges. For those who like that really vintage sound, I strongly encourage you to consider this piano. I'm quite proud to have been able to work on it, regulating it, tuning it. And I also got the finish looking pretty good. It's the original finish. It's mahogany satin. There's some dings on the front here that I was able to wax all over, that I was able to touch up as best as I can. But I'm actually quite pleased with the way I was able to polish up this finish with Old English. It really turned out quite beautiful. It looks very much like a classic early 20th century piece of American furniture, and it even comes with its original matching bench. This does open up the store music. It's a little tight. We've recovered this, but this is the original bench that came with the piano. And this was actually the same, the manufacturer of this bench, I think it was Manual Arts. They were the same company that supplied the Steinway for many years in the early 20th century too. So this bench looks very similar to a Steinway bench at the same time. And Knabe was meant to be really a competitor in their best days to Steinway. I'm not sure if this piano, in all honesty, measures to that. It's a small piano in any case, but I can tell they used good materials, it's well put together, and I'm quite familiar with them now, so I'm always happy with the results I can get on these pianos, and this one's no exception. Now, to rate the tune in particular on this piano, I'll say it's hard to say with mellowness and brightness on a piano with kind of a unique design like this. I'll say it's 5 on a scale from 1 to 10, from mellow to bright, not too much one way or another, but there's so many unique tonal characteristics that aren't really captured by the mellowness and brightness scale, I think characterize Knabe. And I've mentioned in other videos, but there's sort of different tone characters in different parts of the piano, which is something that old pianos in the 1800s were made. In my opinion, that was meant to sort of simulate the different registers of the human voice, and it's no surprise to me that we've actually sold multiple Knabe grands in the past to customers who were professional singers. And as another thing, which I don't think is a coincidence, there's always a plaque on the inside rims of these Knabes that says "Official Piano of the Metropolitan Opera" since 1926. So I think there's something that singers find quite appealing in Knabe pianos, where you get different registers of the piano imitating different registers of the human voice and how they differ from each other and blend. So if you're looking for that type of sound, or if you just like the sound of a vintage sounding piano that isn't quite as old, it's built in 1966, it's an old design and a newer piano, I think you'll be quite pleased with how it turned out. So that's the tone, 5. The touch, I think, is a little bit firm on a scale from 1 to 10. I'll say 6, from light to firm, a little bit more than after none of the resistance in these keys. And of course, like everything else we sell, it has a 10-year warranty on parts and labor, and 100% lifetime trade guarantee. So please stop by, try this out for yourself if you're able to. If you can't make it, you can always give us a phone call or send us an email if you have any questions, but we do hope to see you if you can.